At this time, we are going to have a trumpet solo by my good friend, Brother F.F. Bosworth. Brother Bosworth. Appreciated that. Now I wonder, while you're kind of tuning up there, if we could have a little chorus of Down at the Cross. It's kind of a favor to me. I wonder if you would play it. All right, Brother Bosworth. Say, we're really enjoying our stuff here, this little visit here with Brother and Sister McAnally tonight. I wonder, Brother Hooper, if you got a word, you'd just like to say something in the microphone now.
Sir, I do appreciate this wonderful time we're having together here. Brother Bosworth, Brother Branham, and Brother Sheriff, and others of us here, this Brother McAnally, we're having a time with our lives. Thank the Lord.
Yes, sir. Brother McAnally's next to the best hog hunter in the country. He's the best when I'm gone. All right, I want to have a word from the wife here. All right, honey, what's she going to say?
I'm certainly glad for the privilege I have of being in Arizona, and glad for the privilege I have to meet friends like Brother and Sister McAnally.
Brother Bosworth, what do you think about Arizona and these people here?
I'm just having the most wonderful time. I came clear from Miami out here in one day, flew all the way in one day to be with Brother Brennan. And I've just been tickled pink over the privilege.
We went out hog hunting the other day. We found a lot of tracks, but we didn't find any hogs. We saw plenty of rabbits, but we couldn't find anything that we was looking for. We went out and looked in the same rocks we did a year ago, but there was less tracks than there was a year ago. How about Brother Bosworth playing another little piece?
Well, my dear, everything that you've done for us since we've been on your own this trip, and I trust to Almighty God that someday we can be back together again. God bless you, brother. I've always wanted to hear your wife's voice. Sister McAnally, maybe I'll be many miles away, but when you play this, think of me.
I'm so happy that you all drop in to see us, and so glad that to meet Sister Branham.
Okay, well, thanks, Sister McAnally. That was very, very fine. She's just a little timid woman. I kind of like that old. Brother Bosworth, you got another one on that old trumpet? Well, we'd just like to hear another one for Brother Mike and them. God bless you, brother. All right, Brother Bosworth.
Brother Bosworth. Thanks a whole lot. Brother Hooker, you got another word to say? Nothing to say, honey? Oh, my. Matt, tell us something right quick over this microphone, will you?
Brother Johnny was telling about his hunting trip up in Colorado. He said there was one place up there that was about 10,000 deer, and there was lots of elk. And this year he killed him a 10-point buck, and he shot a bear up there, and he shot a big elk that went over 1,000 pounds. And I sure would like to go up there hunting sometime.
Bye. You want a word to say, Brother Bosworth? Say something else.
Well, I've been having a glorious time being down here with my brother Branham. Strange to say, I have been so busy that I never knew of him, except I heard indirectly but a short time ago. And we have been working many years praying for the sick, holding revivals for something like 35, 40 years. And seen many thousands healed, but we did that without having the gift of healing our brother Branham has. We just used the word, and we knew that the word is the seed. God's word is called the seed. And just like material seed, every seed will do its own work, always, every time in a million, if you treat it right. And so just like the farmer sows his wheat and his oats and his corn and so on, and gets certain results by having the seed in the ground, so the imperishable seed, God's word, will always do exactly what the farmer says, every time in a million. One thing you can be absolutely sure about, before anything happens. Yes. That's one reason I've been glad about holding revival. I know what's going to happen. I want things in God's way. And there's no such thing as a divine promise ever going unfulfilled if we know what our part is. We meet those conditions and make it possible. God is watches over his word to perform it. That's one thing that could always carry out with never a disappointment. Yes. People miss some things that they want because of the fact they haven't been taught enough to get it just high, but it's never because God's unwilling. It's just their lack of knowing how, but I have found in thousands of cases by simple instruction that people can develop this state of faith before things happen.